you know, if I'm ever, you know, I wake up and I need to write the email for the day, or, you know, two or three that day, depending on how I feel that day. I've got a whole list of topics that I could go through, or types of emails that I could go through, but let me kind of do how I most like to do it. I usually like to come up with a ridiculous premise and see how I can relate that to whatever the topic is, whatever your niche is. So I've got a bunch of resources, and I'm more than happy to share those with you, on coming up with wacky ideas for your emails, and then kind of backwards coming up with exactly what the text is going to be, what the copy is going to be. I rarely write the copy first and then do the subject line. I almost always come up with the subject line because I want to have something that's, you know, that catches their eye, something that, what the hell is he talking about, and gets them really curious to open it up. And then, I mean, the biggest mistake that you could make on that, I mean, if I wanted to get almost 100% open rate in my dating niche product, all I would have to say is something like, let's see, Taylor Swift's boobs in this email, open. And I'd probably get a pretty high open rate. You know, if I had that as a call to action, I would probably get a pretty high click-through rate. I don't have that picture, so I always want to make sure that when I do say something in the subject line, it's paid off in the email. So obviously I don't have that picture. It doesn't exist as far as I know. So make sure that it pays off. So why don't I give some of my go-to ways to find really captivating subject lines, and then, you know, we can come up with different ways on how we would go from something that's kind of crazy and out there, and then just tie it into whatever it is that your niche is addressing, whatever problem it is that you solve. So I have just a couple of main resources that I go, if I'm not coming up with any sort of subject line, I will first go to the forums. Just whatever your niche is, go to the forums. Now, this is the easiest way to do it. Go find whatever the most popular post is, whatever's getting the most comments on, whatever's been viewed the most. And some of the forums out there will let you just filter things, filter your search by, you know, what's been viewed the most, what's been responded to the most, what's been at the top of the list the most. And odds are you have a winning headline just right there. You can just go ahead and just totally rip that off and use that as a subject line. And you could do that through all of the different forums that are in your niche. You could do that for all of the top posts that have just been commented on or viewed. That's the easy way. All right. That's kind of almost the no-brainer way to come up with subject lines.
Yeah. Well, I think that's, you know, the smart way to go about it as well. I mean, you could go and say, okay, I can make up a topic that I want to talk about, a subject line that I think might work, but here you are going away and actually seeing, well, finding out what is already working and, you know, making
that. Yeah, I mean, yeah,
as well.
Yeah, everything else is just guesswork. Like, this is not even guesswork. We know this works because it's been proven to work. So you don't even have to really think about it. You don't even have to guess about whether or not it's going to work. You know it's going to work. You've already seen the proof. So that's an easy way to do it. All right, if you want to get a little more creative, a little more silly with it, there is a website that I love to go to and come up with subject lines. Sometimes I'll take them just word for word. Usually I'll have to twist it a little bit so that it fits whatever niche that I'm talking about, but this is my secret weapon right here. It's called headlinesmasher.com. And this is a website that basically takes like two or three clickbait type subjects that aren't really even related and they smash them together. So I can remember one of my favorite ones was dating secrets from a North Korean prison camp. So I would tie that into my dating niche offer, and, you know, how am I going to tie a North Korean prison camp into a dating offer, right? So let's see. There was one called online dating. People talking to people talking to people talking to people talking to Matt. And that was a subject line. I mean, it's ridiculous. But, you know, being able to tie – the art of this is being able to tie whatever ridiculous subject line into your email copy.